After showing a general overview and the concept of the CL-AM1 CV channel in our first video, now it's time to dive deeper into each section. Let's start at the top with the input stage. From the audio side, the input stage consists of a gain pot, an input balance, and L plus R mono and phase switches, which you can also find on the conventional analog CL-AM1 stereo channels. Right next to the gain pot lies the first of seven internal CV sources, fluctuation.
Fluctuation is a random LFO.
The cycle length can be adjusted from 4 seconds to 4 milliseconds. Let's listen to what it does when we route it to the input balance. First, let's patch a pad to the left audio input and another higher pad to the right audio input. Manually turning the input balance pot now pans the two inputs on the input stage from the left audio input to the right audio input. Now, let's choose fluctuation as a CV source using the modulation source pot. When we increase the modulation amount on the input balance, you can hear the input balance being modulated by fluctuation. As the fluctuation is unipolar, we have to turn the input balance fully counterclockwise to have the full range from left to right. Wear headphones to hear the desired effect. Before showing you the envelope follower and gate generator, let's cover the filter section first. The filter is a hybrid between a typical studio equalizer and a smooth synthesizer filter. The parametric midband is an extended version of the conventional AM1 channel EQ high midband. The frequency range reaches from 200 Hz to 10 kHz, with an adjustable Q from 0.5 to 10. At center frequency, the gain range is minus 18 dB to plus 12 dB. Next up, we have a high pass filter that reaches from 30 Hz to 3 kHz and a low pass filter from 20 kHz to 120 Hz. Both with 18 dB per octave slopes. Both filters contain a dry-wet pot that lets you continuously blend between the unfiltered and filtered signal. This offers some very interesting coloring. All of these three bands have an on switch to manually insert the filters into the audio chain. Let's have a listen to how it sounds with a lush pad. Behind the input stage of the AM1 CV channel lie the envelope follower and gate generator. The envelope follower reads the input signal and outputs a control voltage depending on the signal amplitude. With the sensitivity pot, you can adjust the threshold to the incoming signal from low to high. The input source for the envelope follower can be switched between L plus R, R, and external CV input 1, which can also be another audio signal. After adjusting the sensitivity, the envelope follower creates an envelope. The decay time of this envelope can be adjusted with the decay pot, and its curve can be switched from logarithmic to exponential. Furthermore, a gate is generated when the audio signal exceeds the threshold. The gate length is adjustable from short to long. Let's listen to how the envelope follower reacts when we patch an 808 drum beat into the external CV input 1 and use it to modulate the filter section of our previous pad. First, we patch our 808 into external CV input 1 and choose envelope follower as a modulation source for the low-pass filter. Now, let's turn down our low-pass filter and increase the dedicated modulation amount to hear how it sounds. The generated gate could be used to clock sequencers with the trigger output on the back panel. Let's listen to the gate modulating the filter with our previous example.